name is Ryan Neal, and I'm a paranormal investigator. When I was a kid, my experiences with the supernatural terrified me. In college, I decided to found a group dedicated to help those who were haunted like I was. We have Elfie, our occult expert.
Every culture has its ghosts and demons.
Sergi, the tech genius.
The key to every investigation is having the right tools.
Heather, our documentarian.
You never know what you might catch on tape.
And Katrina, our interviewer.
You can learn from every story.
We are the Paranormal Research Society. Everyone, say hi to the newest member of the PRS family. Let's dive straight in. Our case is not far from here, at Poison Springs Park in Arkansas. We got the call from Iris Ramirez, who is the curator there. A potential source of the supernatural activity is that in April 1864, it was the site of a bloody Civil War battle. It was a tremendous loss for the Union that day. Not only that, there were rumors that after the battle, the Confederates and their allies, the local Cherokee tribe, massacred any African-American soldier left on the field.
These cases can get pretty terrifying. You sure you're prepared?
We're so glad to have you along. Let's give you a quick intro to our investigation methods. Check out the glove box. I bet that's our contact, Iris. Can you grab the phone for me? It's somewhere in the back. Goodness, we're pulling into the park now.
No Iris. That combined with the creepy phone call makes me very concerned.
Let's not panic yet. Ryan, why don't you give her a call? Let her know that we've arrived. Maybe we just got our wires crossed.
No can do. This area is pretty remote, and I don't have any reception. I think we're on our own.
We'll start unloading the van so we're nearby in case Iris shows up.
Serge, let's take a tour of the area with our newest team member.
Don't go running off quite yet. Take this. It's a journal for you to record all your experiences and findings in. Hope you like it.
Gives me the goosebumps.
What if it's Iris? Whoa! Did either of you feel that? It was like cold claws down my back.
I didn't feel anything, but it is a lot colder in here. I bet if we break out the EMF meter, we'll see some big-time activity.
We have to start setting up the equipment. Could you grab the EMF from the car? Oh, and let Elfie know about the presence I felt. She's going to want to check it out for herself.
Felt a presence. Heather, Katrina, we need to go. Let's see if we can get the entity on tape.
First experience with an EMF meter. It's pretty simple, just watch the needle. If it starts to move, you can use it to pinpoint areas and items that are being inhabited by spirits.
The presence seems to be centered around the mannequins. I'd start there. Is not something you see every day.
I'm with you. I think it's time to call in the big guns. But you'll have to find a landline somewhere on the property. We'll carry on searching for Iris. I hope she's okay. I think we might have a situation here at Poison Springs. I've brought in Lorraine Warren. There's an entity here, and it is not messing around. Fortunately for us, neither is Lorraine.
This church has been through it all. It practically bleeds history. I'm sensing an ancient presence.
Like what? Maybe a Civil War soldier who never passed on?
Could be. Something unnatural is at work here.
What about Iris? Can you sense anything from her? Is she all right?
Oh my. Yes, she's alive, but in danger. I'm getting images. Here. whatever's haunting this place wants to be found.
Secret room. Nice instincts. With you and Lorraine around, nothing will get past us.
Ah!
Who is doing this? Can you show yourself to us? You okay? I'm afraid we can't get down there safely. You'll have to find the way out, but I'm sure you'll be back with us in no time.
Catch! Sorry, looks like the match is scared.
Thank you. Thank you.
Look at you. Glad you made it out of the basement, okay?
Very impressive. Unfortunately, there's still no sign of Iris. I guess that our best bet for finding her would be somewhere in the museum. Oh no, Iris! Miss Ramirez, I'm Ryan Buell.
Ryan? Sorry to meet under these circumstances. Oh, my back. It hurts.
How did you get these scratch marks?
Scratch marks? Is that what they are? I have no idea. Last thing I remember, I was upstairs writing a note to that archaeologist fella, Dr. Walters.
An archaeologist? Maybe this Dr. Walters has uncovered something in his excavation that has caused all the recent paranormal activity. Where can we find him?
Should be easy in this ghost town. Once into the forest, you'll have to turn right, then left, turn one more time to the left, then go to the right and take your last left. Stay on the trail, and you'll be safe.
Sergi, I need you to stay here and collect as much data as possible on what's happening here. Lorraine, can you stay with Iris? She looks a little shaken up, and I know that you can keep her safe if the presence comes back. Everybody else, let's move out.
Had another sighting in the basement? I wonder if the spirit is trying to communicate with us. I'm going to head down there and see what messages it has.
There's the sign Iris told us about. Parts of it have worn away. If we replace them, we'll have a much easier time getting around.
Well, we've found the camping site. But apart from this tent, it looks deserted.
We're going to interview the workers in the tent. Come check in if you need us. I can't believe it. I think that people here are actually too scared to talk to us.
Maybe I can help. I have a great recipe for a very soothing lemon tea, but it's in my trailer. You'll need to grab some water out of the well, too. Sorry, I'd help more, but I don't feel safe leaving the tent. Things out there have just been too strange recently.
locked. We can't get inside. Something is determined to impede our investigation.
Let's take a deep breath and see if we can get anything to talk to us. Is there anyone out there? We're here to help. Do you have a message for us? Tree? Do you think that's the spirit's name?
Not a bad guess, but my money's on it being about this creepy tree covered with symbols we passed in the forest. I'll take Elfie there. Meet us there after you take a last look around here. What can you tell us about these symbols, or the tree itself? Do they mean anything to you?
The symbols look like they might be Native American. When I was researching the area, I came across an old Cherokee tale of a demon called Spearhand.
What are you doing here? Have you seen her? I can't find her.
Was that a Union soldier? What a powerful spirit to be manifesting so strongly so many years later.
I wonder who he's looking for, and if she's alive or dead.
I'm going to stick around here and see if I can decipher the symbols on the tree. I feel they are related to what is happening here.
We're headed to the camping site. Take care of yourself.
You've got the lemon balm tea. Thank you. Strange things keep happening, and people aren't acting like themselves. Even Iris. Last week I saw her sneaking around with a metal detector in the dead of night. She didn't seem to find what she was searching for, and she broke the metal detector. Her angry screaming at 3 a.m. was the last straw for a lot of people. We're the only ones left.
That's nothing. I was chased out of my trailer by an angry something. I'm head archaeologist on this excavation, researching the Civil War and pre-existing Native American culture. I've waited my whole life for an excavation like this, and now I can't wait to get out of here. But my journal is still back in the trailer, and who knows where the trailer keys are. They fell out of my pocket when I was fleeing from whatever has taken over my home. If you get them back, I'll help your young friend with the carvings on the tree.
Thank you.
You say you found that cigarette case near my keys?
Reminds me of a local ghost story. A Union soldier was marching through the area and dropped his cigarette case. A Cherokee girl named Ayoka found and returned it to him. Not long after, they were in love. Now this was a big no-no because the Cherokee were allied with the Confederates.
What happened next?
Well, that's where the story gets strange. Allegedly, Ayoka's father was a shaman and was trying to summon a demon to fight for the Confederate army. She and Edward died to stop him. And it seems like the Confederates couldn't win the war without their demon.
We've seen the soldier, and now stories of a demon. It's hard to say what we're actually up against. Best to be prepared. I'll introduce Dr. Gibson to Elfie, but I'd suggest that you grab the thermal camera from Sergi. Sounds like you'll need it for the trailer.
Traitor Edward Hargreaves' cigarette case?
Traitor? I thought he was a Union soldier who died for the cause.
You been talking to that fool, Dr. Gibson Walters, too? Don't believe that romantic nonsense he spins. Hargreaves was no hero. That turncoat betrayed the soldiers who trusted him, striking in a deal with the Confederate allied Cherokee. The Battle of Poison Spring was a huge loss for the Union soldiers, because of the native presence on the field. This cigarette case is a great find, though, historically speaking. Would you let Dr. Walters know it's very important to me? I mean, can I use it as an exhibit?
I bet you came for the thermal cam, huh? It's ready to go, but could you help me analyze these images first? They should be the same, but they don't look quite right. Wow, there were that many differences? These photos were taken 10 minutes apart, all while I sat right there. I can't believe it. Thanks. Here's the thermal camera.
We're very close to a breakthrough here, so I'm going to send you into the trailer alone to retrieve Dr. Walter's journal. I know you can handle it. Come back safe, and soon.
Dr. Walters, here's your journal. You were right, the presence in your trailer was very strong.
It makes us wonder, with seeing the ghost of Ayoka in your trailer, do you think your excavation could have uncovered something or caused the haunting?
There was a dig I led recently where I found a carved deer skull. It seemed a basic Cherokee artifact. Strange things started to happen after it came out of the ground.
Where's the deer skull now?
We kept all the artifacts in the nearby Forester's Lodge. But I haven't been back since the hauntings got so bad.
Seems clear to me what we need to do next, team. Let's go to the Forester's Lodge and check it out.
After all I've done to help and you give it away? We needed that to keep everyone safe. I won't let you help it!
Can you hear that? I think I can still hear Edward muttering. Can you grab the electronic voice phenomenon recorder from Sergi? It's crucial we learn what Edward meant, especially if he's trying to help us. I'll handle the locked door here.
We figured it out. The symbols on the tree were carved to chain evil spirits to an area near here. I need a dowsing rod to learn more. Can you keep an eye out for one?
I'm sorry I can't just give you the EVP recorder. Someone or something destroyed ours. I'll help you build a new one, but we need some parts. Katrina has my backup recorder, and we'll also need to find a pair of headphones.
We need something else too, but it's a little embarrassing. I may have hidden a bug in Iris's office. Look, I kept hearing shouting and muttering, almost as if she was fighting with herself. But nothing since Lorraine's been up there. Here's another part for the EVP recorder. It was the only one that wasn't smashed.
Now I can find where the evil spirits are supposed to be trapped. Thank you. Here, maybe this claw I found will come in handy.
Who could have destroyed the EVP recorder? Iris is the only person we've seen near there, but she wouldn't, right? Well, the recorder's all yours. You can grab it off the table.
got the door open. Let's see if we can find that carved deer skull.
I won't help them.
The spirit seems very upset, but I need him to calm down before I can figure out why. He keeps repeating,
Stick is key. The talking stick. Fear its power. It will try to get it. Be aware. Talking stick.
Thank you.
you all right? You were gone for quite a while. As you can see, we've had a bit of excitement too. The roof came crashing down as we tried to speak to Edward.
I felt a strange power, and I don't think it was Edward or Ayoka. Can you fix the lock on my bag? There's a divining pendulum in there I'd like to use to check this place.
We weren't able to get to the lodge's back room. But maybe if we go through the attic, we'll have a shot. But be careful up there.
Ah, well done with the broken lock. I'm intrigued to see what the spirits want to show us here. I don't know what spirit guided us here, but they seem to want us to use this engraved bead for something. Perhaps as part of the shaman's stick Edward is obsessing over. Thank you. Walters was right. There was a ritual to summon a demon to fight for the Confederates. Edward and Ayoka broke the shaman stick to stop it, but it backfired, and when the stick shattered, it also tore their souls apart.
We can't be one again, until it is.
But why do you continue to feel dark demon energy here if the demon was banished?
You're right. The demon should have been sent back to whence it came. But I think the fracturing of the ritual may have caused it to become trapped here in spirit form, but with no physical body.
I fear this demon may cause more mischief if he gets to remain on this plane. We must complete the shaman stick and banish it fully, and I bet the old tree is the place to do it.
Thank you.
Ioka! It's me, Edward. Where are you? I need you.
It's you, Edward, at last. To have you back in my arms after all these years. Thank you for this. But we can't rest in peace yet, as the demon is still trapped here with us. You must call its name and reverse the summoning ritual to banish it forever. You will yet need two physical items that are of Edward's in my past. Take them back to the cave where it all began. There's a totem pole in front of its entrance. We will wait for you there. But watch out. This demon is weak, but it'll try to restore its power.
No! I won't let you!
Thank you.
Wait, where's Elfie?
Something is going on. She wouldn't leave this place without telling us first.
We need to split up and find her.
Wait. We've found out something that everyone needs to know first. The name of the demon.
The other employees finally started talking to us. Apparently, in Cherokee lore, there's a demon named Spearhand, who's incredibly strong and has stone flesh that makes it impossible to wound. It lives in caves and cuts the backs of its victims to eat their organs.
As a Cherokee demon, that explains why Ayoka's father was summoning it. And if it is as fearsome as it sounds, why they gave their lives to stop it.
It also explains the icy fingers I felt on my back earlier, and why Iris's back was covered in scratches. We're one step closer to banishing the demon. But Elfie going missing right now makes me very worried. While we look for her, you must keep pushing forward. Will you talk to Iris? I'm sure she can tell us where the caves are in this area.
Wait, Iris just ran out in front of me into the forest. She looked crazed. She's been a friend for a long time, but recently I don't even know who she is anymore. She dropped this. Here, take it, and I'm out of here.
Elfie's missing and Iris has run off. This is all very strange and seems unlikely to be coincidental. Let's check out her office. Maybe there's something about the cave there. Strange. All the information on Iris's thumb drive is about Cherokee magic and rituals.
That, coupled with all the reports of Iris's odd behavior. Do you think Iris is possessed by the demon?
She must be. So it was Iris who smashed our EVP and locked the newbie in the haunted trailer. She must have been possessed after she called us to get rid of Edward and Ayoka.
It looks like we'll have to do an exorcism at the same time as the banishing ritual. But Heather, what if she did something to Elfie to try and stop us from banishing the demon?
Elfie's tough. If we find the ritual cave, I bet we'll find her there. Let's head up to the church tower. We'll have the best chance of spotting the totem pole Ayoka mentioned from there. goodness, you found me. I thought I'd be stuck down here forever. This is the cave where the ritual took place nearly 150 years ago. Now it's time to finally send that demon back. First, we need one item that belonged to each of our young lovers and was with them during the ritual. Ayoka's necklace and Edward's cigarette case will work perfectly. I think there are instructions on how to perform the ritual on the wall, but they've been obscured from me by the demon's dark energy. Perhaps you could see through it with the EMF. In fact, I'd use all of our gadgets in this cave before we start the ritual to make sure there are no missteps hidden from us by Spearhand.
In the shadow. Hurry up, it's coming.
Thank you.
working on the ritual. Please make sure none of the team's been hurt.
Elfie, are you all right? I can't believe I didn't find you. You were nearly under our noses. If not for that loud bang and the wisp of smoke, I'd still be looking.
I was dowsing the trail of energy to find where the demon was trapped, and the earth beneath me collapsed. I think I sprained my ankle, so I'm a bit stuck. But the good news is, we're nearly ready to exorcise the demon. Well, I wouldn't stand over the hole for long. There's about to be a lot more smoke. The ritual requires us to trace arcane symbols in the smoke to bind the demon back to its world.
We're on our way to help, but don't wait for us to start the ritual. Nothing is more important than exorcising the demon from Iris. Of the ritual, you are bound back to the darkness from whence you came.
We cast you out, Spearhand.
No!
What happened? Where am I?
I can feel the dark presence no more. I believe you have come back to yourself, Iris.
Such an evil should never have been called to this world. I don't want to think how the war would have ended with such an opponent. Thank you for finally making this place safe from its power.
And thank you for what you have done for us. We're together once more, and forever. Come, Edward, my love. It's time for us to rest. Goodbye, and good luck.